The coronavirus is on track to become the leading cause of death in the United States. According to new projections from the University of Washington, more than 315,000 Americans will die from the virus by December 1st. 315,000 Americans by December 1st if current patterns continue, pushing the virus ahead of heart disease and cancer. That is 138,000 new deaths in just 3 months, on top of the roughly 179,000 who have died so far. Dr. Bob Lahida is here to help break down some of these numbers and the major medical news and developments when it comes to combating coronavirus. Doctor, these numbers, these are stark numbers. These are frightening numbers. It's just so hard to comprehend how this country, which wants to believe that we are the, we're exceptional, that, you know, there is no country like the United States on earth. Well, it's proving to be true when it comes specifically to this coronavirus. I mean, when you see numbers like that, what goes through your mind?
Well, I think of freedom of expression. And I think that people either will or will not mitigate. That means wear masks and have social distancing and wash their hands. I mean, there are a lot of people out there who think that wearing a mask is an infringement of their civil liberties. And I think that's what we're seeing. We're seeing people infected because of their inability to keep the certain protocols that have been put in place, such as wearing a mask and understanding the transmission of the virus between symptomatic and asymptomatic people in closed spaces. And it's simply American. And this has a toll. It has a toll it's taking on our society, and the numbers of deaths are going to continue to rise, I fear. And in the fall, when things get colder and influenza comes in at the same time, we're going to see really some big numbers, which may actually exceed the numbers, Vlad, that you presented on the screen. And that's very worrisome for us in medicine, simply because it means that we may resort back to our March and April chaos. That's the only word I can think of, chaos, until we get a vaccine. Vlad?
Oh, man. So, you know, speaking of maybe not chaos, but certainly confusion, the CDC sort of left people sort of scratching their head, right? The CDC changed some guidelines on testing, and then people reacted to it, especially in the medical community, and then they sort of clarified those changes. The CDC previously recommended a testing for anyone who came in close contact with an infected person. Sounds reasonable. This week, the agency revised that, saying that people exposed to the virus who don't show symptoms may not need to be tested. So we've been told that contact tracing is key to trying to stop COVID-19, the pandemic. How does this sort of interfere with that process?
Well, first of all, the CDC's commentary about no testing without symptoms was totally different than what we in medicine believe should be done. Anne-Marie, you mentioned that we have to track patients. We have to track people. And 40% of the people that are infected don't have symptoms. And they are most infective right before the symptoms come on. So no testing without symptoms, despite the fact that enough testing materials are present. We know that. And we think that all close contacts of people who are infected should be tested. Now, Dr. Redfield backed up this morning, I believe, and said, yes, that is correct. We should be testing all close contacts of people who are infected. Asymptomatic carriers should definitely be identified. People are most contagious, as I said, right before symptoms appear. And more importantly, we have enough testing in the country. We have millions and millions of tests that are available and that should be used. And this is important. And by the way, we're getting more and more tests that are rapid tests. I've heard of a test this morning out of China, which involves the CRISPR technology, which is a molecular technology that it will supplant the PCR testing that took 10 days to 2 weeks to get results back. This test gives you results back in 40 minutes. And that's very, very exciting. And it's very specific for the coronavirus 19.
Well, that is good news, because that's what we need. And a vaccine, of course. Dr. Bob Lahida, thank you so much.
Thanks, Anne-Marie.